VoxEdit.
Welcome to Voxelize. In this tutorial, we're going to build a model in VoxEdit and learn how to break it down into pieces that are ready for rigging and animation. If you're not already familiar with the modeling tools in VoxEdit, check out my previous video that details every tool and function of the modeler mode first. There's a link to it up here and in the video description. This video is sponsored by the Sandbox Creator Fund, which pays artists to create assets for the upcoming game, The Sandbox. VoxEdit is the totally free tool designed for creating assets for The Sandbox. To learn more about the Creator Fund, or to join the Sandbox Discord to talk to the artists and developers, check out the links in the description. You may notice that I'm using alpha version 0.9.0, which as of the time of this recording is not available for download on the VoxEdit website. I'm currently using a pre-release version so I can show you some of the cool new features that are coming soon. Keep in mind that there may be some changes to the way things look when this update is released publicly. We're going to start off by creating a new rig. We could start off with the modeler, but by creating the rig first, we'll be able to jump back and forth between modes easily later on. We'll go over the rigging interface in the next video, so for now, all we're focused on is the library panel on the right. Clicking the drop-down menu, we're going to select New VXM and name of the file. I'm going to be creating this little monster trapped in his egg, who's going to look pretty much like Digitamamon from Digimon way back when. I'm calling him Eggsby. First off, I get rid of the default palette. It's not really necessary, but it helps keep me organized. Then I add in my own colors. Next, I turn on X and Z symmetry so I can build more quickly. I also turn on the grid view so I can more easily see what I'm doing. I begin modeling by creating the eggshell. You can Google image search for pixel art circles or Minecraft spheres if you need a guide on creating round shapes using blocks. After building up a few layers and keeping the inside hollow, I add in some of the white placeholder blocks so the green body is not directly placed on the edge of the shell. Switching over to the face tool, I quickly build up the body and the shell. Halfway up the shell, I switch to the white swatch, adding two layers which will be the crack the monster peeks through. Two more layers of eggshell and then I can start tapering to the top point of the egg. Taking a quick spin, this egg looks pretty good. I need to make room for the legs, so I shift everything up a few steps. Don't forget to turn off the Z-axis mirroring, so changes left and right still mirror, but front to back don't apply, unless you want a monster with eyes on the back of his head. Rotating to view the bottom, I carve out a 3x3 hole and start adding a leg with claws. The last detail for this model is making the eggshell crack. I turn off the X mirroring so the crack can be unique all the way around. I remove a voxel from the top shell and add a matching one to the bottom. I switch it up as I go around the shell so I get a nice jagged appearance. Now that the model is done, I click the rig button and select yes when it asks me to save. Back in the rigger, I go to the library panel and click the duplicate button that looks like two squares on top of the model icon. This prompts me to give a name for a new object. I make an Eggsby leg file. I only need one because both left and right legs on this model are identical. And then I make two more duplicate files, one for the bottom half and one for the top half. After clicking on the edit pencil for the leg model, I right-click and delete the swatches for the colors not used on the eggs, leaving only bright green and pale green. Then using the flood erase, I remove one of the legs entirely. I add two more layers to the top of the leg, so as it moves inside the model, the legs won't look like they're floating. Then I trim the bounding box to fit the model. Next, I use the pivot tool to select where I want the leg to swing from. If you don't see the arrow handles for the pivot tool, you may need to zoom out to find them. I select the center of the leg and a voxel below the hip. Back to the rigger, I move on to the top. The only piece here will be the shell, so I delete all the other colors and use the flood erase to remove the bottom half. Then I trim and center the pivot point. Finally, to the bottom half, I remove the leg colors and flood erase the top shell. Again, trim and center the pivot. I know you're excited to jump right into rigging and animation, but I'll need to show you all the tools and panels in rigging mode first. In the next video, I'll be covering all of that, plus creating your first couple animations. Thank you for watching and let me know your questions down in the comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and whack the bell for a notification when the rigging and animation video is ready.